Hi everyone, welcome to the second part of Azure DevOps tutorial. In the previous part we learned about what is DevOps. Now in this part we will learn what is Azure DevOps. Let's start. Let's have a look on the agenda of this video. In this video we will learn what is Azure DevOps, what is the relation between Azure and Azure DevOps, are they same, are they different, and what is the relation. We will learn about Azure DevOps services. We will learn about Azure DevOps server. Also, we will learn what is the relationship of VSTS and the Azure DevOps. Before everything, let's understand what is Azure DevOps. Azure DevOps is a set of modern services which is used to plan smarter, collaborate better, and ship faster. So basically, this is a development lifecycle of any product. First, you have to plan, then you have to work, and then you have to deploy. So in another way, we can say that you have to plan in a smart way for the success of the product. You have to collaborate better. You have to work on the code management on the development side. And at the last, for the shipping, you have to focus on the deployment part. So Azure DevOps is a set of modern services which provides all these features. Azure DevOps provides all these features. You can use all of them, or you can choose from these services as per your need or role. If you are coming from a particular role, just like the product owner, then you can work on a particular service of the Azure DevOps. If you are coming from the development side, then you can focus on a particular service. Or if you are coming from a different background, then you can choose any service as per your requirement. Also, on the other side, you can choose all of them, or you can choose any one of them as per your requirement. Azure DevOps is developed and managed, maintained by Microsoft. That's why we can say Azure is very fast, very secure, and very reliable product for the DevOps. Azure DevOps was formerly known as Visual Studio Team Services, that is VSTS. So if you are not new in the .NET development, then you must know about the VSTS. Earlier, it used to be the VSTS. Now the Microsoft has changed its name. It is renamed to Azure DevOps. Azure DevOps provides a set of integrated features that you can access through your web browser. So basically, in the simple term, we can say it is a website which can be accessed with the help of a browser and the internet. Let's understand about the relationship in between Azure and Azure DevOps. Azure is a cloud solution which provides lots of services and features. Why? To help your organization in almost all ways during the development of any product by providing multiple tools and technologies. So basically, Azure is a cloud solution, and this cloud solution provides lots of features which are required for your company. It is used for the development, for the deployment, for the management of other things also. Irrespective of technologies, there are lots of technologies which you can use in the Azure. It provides you storage, it provides you lots of other things. Now, what is Azure DevOps? Azure DevOps is a feature or service of Azure. In the simple term, we can say Azure is something very broad, and Azure DevOps is a part of Azure. Or we can say Azure DevOps is a feature of Azure. If we talk about the graphic representation, we can say Azure is something which is very big, and Azure DevOps is a part of this big feature. Now let's understand the main point which is available in the Azure DevOps, Azure DevOps services. There are five services which are available in Azure DevOps. First one is boards. Second is repos. Third is pipeline, test plan, and at the last we have artifacts. So this is all about Azure DevOps. In the Azure DevOps, there are five services. You can choose any one of them, you can work on all of them, but for the success of any product, all these five services are required. Let's talk about the each services. First, we have boards. Boards are basically used to plan your work. Here in this boards, you can write your stories, you can write your task, your bugs or your epics, and you can manage their progress, complete, to do all these things. The agile board, the kanban board, all these things are managed in the boards. Then we have repos. Repo is basically something related to your code. In these repos, basically it is repository. You can use the TFS repository, You can use TFS or the Git, and you can manage your code. You can create branches, you can create multiple repositories in your project. You can use all the features which are available from the Git. Then we have pipeline. Pipeline is something related to the deployment of your code. So all the tasks, the automation process, the CI/CD, everything will be available in the pipeline. We have the test plan. So basically, testing is also one of the main feature in the development. The automation testing, the manual testing, all these things can be taken care in the test plans. At the last, we have artifacts. Artifact is basically a collection of your packages which you are getting from the private repository or the public repository, which you need to share among your team. Also, these are required for the deployment. So basically, in the artifacts, you can store your packages which are simply required for the development. In this entire tutorial of Azure DevOps, we will learn all these services in very detail and one by one. Now let's understand how can we choose the Azure DevOps server. Lots of companies do not want to use cloud because they do not want their data to be stored on some other server. They want to store data on their own server. There are lots of scenarios where companies love the idea of the cloud. They basically love how to work with the resources, how to create resource, how to delete resource, all these things. But ultimately, if you are working about the cloud, then your data will be stored at some other place, which they do not want to do. They want their data to be stored in their own premises. So if you are working with the Azure DevOps, then we have two options to choose the server. First one is cloud and the second one is on premises. If you do not have your own setup, you do not have your own servers, then you can use cloud servers. So basically, whenever you will create a project or an organization in the Azure DevOps, then you have to choose the region where your data will be stored. And second is on premises. If you do not want to use the server of the Azure DevOps, then you can use your own premises server and everything, all the data will be stored in your premises. Now let's have a look what is the relationship of VSTS to Azure DevOps. On September 10, 2018, Microsoft renamed VSTS to Azure DevOps Services. So earlier it was known from the name of VSTS, which was Visual Studio Team Services, but now after 10th September 2018, it is known as Azure DevOps Services. These are some features which were known in the VSTS, and now if you are talking about the Azure DevOps, then what are the names of the new features? In the VSTS, we were having build and release. Here in the Azure DevOps, it is known as Azure Pipelines. In the VSTS, we were having code. Here it is known as Azure Repos. In the VSTS, we were having work. Here in the Azure DevOps, this is known as Azure Boards. In the VSTS, we were having test. Here it is known as Azure Test Plans. On the VSTS, we were having packages, but here on the DevOps, it is known as Azure Artifacts. That is all in this part. I hope you will like this video. If you like the video, hit the like button. You can tell me your feedback in the comment section, or if you have any question regarding to anything, you can ask me in the comment section. You can share this video and please subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.